Hello people of YouTube and welcome to the continuation of my long ass list of filming equipment. As I said in the first part, these two videos are mainly aimed at other YouTubers or people with a general interest for motion picture production hardware. But if you are not interested in those two things, I'll try to keep this as light and snappy as possible, so it might be a little bit interesting for you to watch as well. Let's go! So in the last video we ended with audio equipment, now we will continue with lighting, and I can keep this a little bit shorter. First off, I have a Falcon Eyes ring light with a little diffuser, which is really nice for situations like this. My second light is another ring light, but this time a really small one which mounts on top of the camera. This is an Aperture Amran with about 100 dimmable LEDs, and this light is really nice for example, when I go outside at night and do some handheld running gun work, or for example for macro or portrait photography. Last but not least, I have this reflector with a silver and a white side, which I am using at this moment right now because the sun behind me is really bright and I'm bouncing that sunlight onto my face. Really handy and sort of a natural way to produce light. And it's really nice for when you're going on a shoot with multiple people, which I really need to do more often. Then let's go on to equipment support. My only tripod, a Hama Star, is a flimsy piece of shit, to be honest, but it's perfectly fine for shots without movement like this one. Then I have a Slick monopod, which is really high build quality for the price it came at, which is really nice. It only misses like a ball head on the top, but I can order that separately later. For the ring light, I have a pretty flimsy but really tall stand, which is really quite nice. It goes up to about 2 meters and 10 centimeters, something like that. So it's really nice and high above me when I'm standing and filming. Also, a while ago I got crafty and I built this little bracket sort of thing, which folds around my camera really nicely, and it holds up my like little ring light and the audio recorder and the video mic for when I go outside and do running gun shooting. But get crafty every now and then, get creative, and something random like this may pop out of that process, and it really works fine. Last thing, which I made about a year ago, is this boom pole for my Rode video mic, which, just like the reflector, is only coming in handy when I'm shooting outdoors with other people. Obviously, I also need to carry all of this stuff around the place, and for that I have this Manfrotto chest strap backpack. I also have a small Tamron DSLR, well, pouch, I'd almost say, and I have a crate. Oh yeah, and I also have this guy, who now has his driver's license and can drive me around the place. Thanks, Frank. For last category, editing. I do that with this, on this, or this. This is a very well cooled PC with a slightly overclocked AMD FX6100 inside of it. It has an HIS Radeon HD7850 video card, and it also has 8 GB of RAM, of which I suppose it could use a bit more, but it's fine for now. This is a Dell Inspiron 15 5000 with an Intel i7 processor inside of it, then an AMD Radeon R7 M265, and also 8 GB of RAM. And then this is the Adobe Creative Cloud, of which I use Adobe Premiere Pro for the editing, After Effects for composing every now and then when I try. I use SpeedGrade for color grading all the stuff that I make, and Photoshop and all that sort of programs for the thumbnails. You tired yet? I'm quite tired. You can see by the background and the lighting that this recording has taken quite a long time. And finally, last, potentially least, but still quite important, storage, which is often overlooked. My Legria Mini X records at a maximum bitrate of 24 MB per second. And with that camera, I use a SanDisk Ultra 16 GB with a speed of 30 megabytes per second. I used to have this card in my EOS 600D, but because the writing speed of that card is too slow, it constantly stopped recording. So if you have problems with like your camera stopping to record, upgrade to a higher speed SD card, because that is the cause of the problem. Then after I found that out, I got myself a SanDisk, also 16 GB, which writes at about 80-ish MB per second, which is slightly overkill, but at least I know that my camera doesn't randomly stop recording. Both cards, because they are just 16 gigabytes and I do record in full HD all the time, overflow, if that were possible, quite easily. They fill up so easily, and I'm currently looking for a bigger SD card, like a 32 or a 64 gigabyte SD card, especially for my 600D, because that just fills up so fast. Also, I recently got myself a Seagate 1 TB external hard drive, on which I like transport all of the raw footage that I shot and all of the Premiere projects from the computer to my laptop, which is really nice to have, and I can recommend that for anyone, whether it's for backing up or like transportation purposes. And ladies and gentlemen, can you believe it? We are done. That was a lot of stuff to take in, wasn't it? I think it was. If you did make it all the way through both videos, comment it down below, because I'm really quite curious to see who is still watching at this point, if anyone. And more importantly, why are you still watching? Kind of curious about that as well, so comment that down below. Lastly, I want to give a shout out again to Amy, who helped me shoot the B-roll for this video and the previous one as well. Link to her channel obviously is in the description below, yeah, so go and check her out. Thank you very much for watching, if you are still here obviously, and well, don't forget to randomly push some of the positive buttons down below, and I will see you next time. Ciao.